Hello guys, welcome to Web Development for Kids and Teens. Hope you guys are having fun, right? Just a reminder, you know, when I say kids and teens, it means 8 years plus. You know, even if you are 70 years old, you know, you should be able to follow this, right? So we've come a long way, right? This is lesson 12, you know, and we've done nice and cool things that are really proud of you guys, you know, if you are following this video and you're able to do all of this, right? So this is where we are at right now. We have our personal website, and we did some great cool stuff in there, and in the last video we were able to push our code to GitHub, right? I show you guys how to use GitHub, which is really good. GitHub is what professionals, people that work with Google, with Microsoft, you know, with Facebook, you know, with Roblox, they all use GitHub, okay? So that's a very good one, right? But we have one issue, right? Our website is not good on a mobile phone, you know? It's not mobile responsive, right? You know, it looks so bad on mobile phones, right? And most of our users are gonna be looking at our website on their phones, right? So as a good web developer, we have to kind of fix that, right? So that's what today's video is about. It's gonna be probably a little bit long and interesting, but make sure that you follow all the steps and make sure that you are learning, right? If you are writing, if I write something and I don't explain and you need explanation, please put any question in the comment section and I will answer your question, or you could just Google anything, you know. If I write something and you don't know what it is, just Google it, you know, you understand, okay? Make sure that you are learning. Okay, so let's see how our website looks on your mobile phone, right? I told you guys how to see your website in the mobile view. Now use Google Chrome, right? Don't use Microsoft Edge, Internet Explorer, or even Safari. No, use Google Chrome, okay? So in Google Chrome, what you want to do is you right click and you say inspect, right? So let's see. So this is how our website is. So let me, you can choose any fonts and all of that, you know, and so it's kind of small, right? And this is kind of small, you know, before it used to overlap, right? You see this contact me will come down here, it's kind of so weird, right? So that's what we want to fix, right? So the first thing that we want to do is when we are in mobile view, right, we want this menu to go away and we want it to be like a drop down menu, right? I'll show you guys what it is, you know. So just then again, when we're in mobile view, we don't want this to show at all, right? That's what they're gonna do on index page. When we're on mobile view, we don't want this to show. When we're on mobile view, we don't want this to show, but we want this to show as a menu. So we just click a button here and it will just come down, right? That's what we want to do, all right? So let's get started. So on our index page, so the first thing that we need to do, so I'm gonna copy some codes, 2 lines of code. So what I will do, I'll put this in the comment section because I don't want you guys to make a mistake. So these 2 lines of code, might not see. Let me see if I can move this backward now. Okay. So but anyways, these 2 lines of code, I'll put it in the comment section, right? So this first one is going to this website, like this URL, you know, to get some icons. So the icon that we're going to use to click to drop down our menu, right, we're going to get that in here. Then this one is kind of used, you know, to kind of scale our website when we are using mobile phones, right? Like different kind of screens, right? So again, I'll put this in the comment section, just in the description rather. So you just copy and paste it, right? But if you really want to type it, you can type it too. You can just pause the video. I mean, it's good to type actually, but you can make a mistake. So I'll advise to just copy. All right, so we do this. Then let's see how our website is. See, it looks really nice. Well, let's work with iPhone 12 Pro. Okay, so you see everything looks, yeah, not good. Okay, so the first thing that we want to do, we want to like when we are mobile view, we want this to go, and we can do that in CSS. Okay, so now let's go to our CSS. Let's come down here. So what we want to do is let me also copy something. You know, maybe it's be better for me to type it actually. So you say add media screen and max width 780 pixel. I'll explain this, okay? But let me just try to type the code. All right, so nav underscore d display none. Okay, what I just did right here, so I say that if the screen that I'm using, you know, so if the maximum width is like 780, right, don't display my nav div. And this is my nav div, right? See this, right? I'm saying display none. I'm saying if my width, if the maximum width that I have is 780 pixel, don't display my navigation for now. We are going to replace it with something else. So I want you to pause and see how this is gonna look. So let's refresh this now. See, it is gone, right? And if you want to see how it's gonna come back, so click here, click on responsive. So the responsive will allow you to drag your screen. So you see, when we move closer, when we get to like 781, it comes back, right? Because we said 780. But I think we should increase it actually. So that is 785, right? So that means till we have 785, it won't show until we have 786. I think I should make it, let's see, 890. 90, okay. Yes. Good. All right. So let's take it back to iPhone 12 Pro and refresh. All right. So again, when we are on this view, we don't want to see this footer at all. All right. So let's go back and see where is our footer in here. So these are our footer, ID footer, okay. So we just do the same thing and say in here, ID footer, don't display it. And we do that by saying display none, right? Okay, good. So that is gone. So now we want to put our menu in here so that when we are on this view, this menu is gonna show. So how do we do that? So we are gonna have a kind of duplicate of our nav div. but not really duplicates, okay? And I'm gonna copy it now. So just under the nav div here, to some new line. Let me get the code. So I'm gonna copy and paste the code because I'm lazy, but you guys should type it out, okay? All right. So I mean, you don't have to put a comment, but it might be good for you guys to put a comment in there, okay? So again, it's just like this one, yeah, you know, but it's just for the mobile view. So this is the class, these are all the links. Then this is the icon that will show. No, this is a link for the icon, right? Then there's a JavaScript function here. I've not taught you guys JavaScript function, but just type it accordingly, right? Don't make any mistake. Just type it the way it is. You don't have to worry about this comment, okay? But just type it this way, the way it looks like this, okay? Then you see we have some CSS that we need to define. We have top nav, my links and icons. So I'm gonna copy some CSS stuff for us. It's gonna be a long one, but make sure you copy everything. Okay, let's do this. All right. So there's gonna be a long line. And this one should be before this media, okay? This media should be the last thing, okay? So in here, so it's gonna start from here. So you start typing from here till here. So pause the video and type all of this, okay? So type all of this. So when you are done, so let's see how our view gonna look like. Did I save it? I did save it. Okay, yeah, I think I need to define my JavaScript function. Give me a second. So the JavaScript is gonna be this. So and you want to put JavaScript, so come down here where the footer is, do a new line and put this in here. Okay, make sure that everything looks the same. Okay, please make sure everything looks the same. The icon is still not showing. That is strange. Let's see. Class icon. Am I missing something? See top nav. Okay, I think I need to put this one in here. So at the beginning here, put this in here. Top nav, that's my class. Just keep coming back there. Yes, okay, that makes sense. Right, so now this is showing. You see now, when I click on this, it's showing me this. Okay, so this is what we want to have. And when I go away from mobile view, you see, it's gonna disappear. When I go into mobile view, it's gonna come up, right? So I guess that's all we need to do for the. The index page, I guess. I think that's all. So everything is working fine. I can go to About Me. See, About Me looks so weird. We're gonna fix it. Okay. So the next page that we want to fix, just like we just saw, is About Me. Let's fix this. So let's go to About Me. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is to put those two lines in here, right? Remember? So we come to the from top here, copy all of this. It's gonna be the same thing actually, so it shouldn't take too much time. So copy and paste. That is that. Then you see, we don't want this to show up when we're on a mobile view, right? So you copy it. That's the body. Wait. No, this is supposed to be this nav about. So just like we have nav div in here, you can put it right here. So when we're on mobile view, we don't want this to show display. It's not. Okay. Hope you guys are following. Okay. So that's good. So now when we're on mobile view, the navigation that we want to show is gonna be this. So all of this, right? Remember, I'll just copy all of this and we'll paste it in here. That's it, right? Then the next thing that we need is our JavaScript down here. So you copy this one, so you come and put it the last div before the body closes, right? You do this, okay? You do all of that, okay? So do we have any other thing that we need to do? Okay, so let's see how this looks now. Okay, it's coming along. I think I did some changes in the CSS. Okay, so let's go to where we define our div one about. Let me see. This one, this class, div1 about. Let's look for it. Okay. So we're gonna remove all of this one. Okay. We're gonna have only float left. Okay. So and let me see, what does that change? Then my profile image too. The profile image, don't forget to change this, okay? Then the profile image is this. I didn't change it in here, but down here when we're on mobile view, I want that profile page to be something else, okay? And this is what I want it to be. All right, sounds good. So let's see what we got. Okay, good. This is how I want it to look. Okay. So now it's showing properly. This is how it's supposed to show on the phone. Then I can click on this, it's gonna come. I can go to home. I can go to About Me. And the view is gonna be fine. Right, don't forget, you need to change the profile image. I mean, I have a profile image in here, inside here, right? This one will not change. The div one about, everything that you have is going to be removed except float left, and you should be good with that. So now we are good with our home page. We are good with our About Me. Let's go to projects. Your project is not looking good at all. Okay, so again, the same thing. We're gonna go to my project. The first thing that we need to do, we copy these two lines of code, put it in here. Again, these two lines of code, I'll put it in the description, okay? Hopefully I don't forget that. Then the next thing that we want to do, so the nav for project is also nav about, so and I think it's covered in here, nav about in here, so we're good for that. Okay, so the next thing we want, the navigation for our mobile, you can copy it from anywhere. Give me a second. Okay, this one is okay. Okay, let me do something. So come in here again, copy from here, and paste it here. All right. Then our JavaScript. Don't forget, my project right now is what we're working on. So the div before this body closes. Oh, I didn't copy it right. Okay. So I think that should be all for project. So let's see how this looks. Number one, you see this thing is here, but the color is white. So we need to change the color to something else. So let's go to where the this is it in here. So let's give it a class. Let's call it icon underscore back. You can call it something else, you know, back. Right. Then in my CSS, I'm gonna have something like this. Put it before this, okay? Oh yeah, I think I have it already anyways. So I have it and I give it blue. And I gave it blue because blue is my theme color, right? So you want to give it your own theme color. Then I'll put this one in here. Yeah. So this is black, this is icon back. So when I refresh it, it should come up. Yeah, that is right there. So I don't like the way this text looks big, but I guess we can leave it that way. But anyways, yeah, so now this works fine. About me, my project. It's good. Let me see if we can make any modification to that. I guess we can leave it this way. Right. Give me a second. See. The font size. is this? Yeah, I think I'm gonna remove that font size. So where we have our project info, this project info, look for it in here. I just remove this guy. Okay. It's gonna look better now. Yeah. It looks more like it now. So video game is the next one. So I'm not removing this footer because it's scrolling, right? So but if you want to remove it, you can remove it, right? So so for example, if this is not scrolling for you and you want to remove it, all you have to do is come to your games, go to where wait, this is not it. I call it my games, okay? Go to where this is. So just copy this. So it's ID. So just come here. ID start with pound sign, right? Then you say display none. And it will go away, okay? Oh, we have to do this first. Oh, my bad. Yeah, we have to copy this. See, and it goes away, right? But because mine is scrolling, I still want it, okay? But if you don't want it, you can do this. Yeah, it's scrolling. You know, it's kind of big. Yeah. So let's do the one for this one. So for games, it is nav game. And it's a class. So you come here and call it class nav game. Display. Can you guess what that is? None. So anytime you make any change, please view it, right? See if you make mistake or not. So this should disappear. That's very good. So now we want our icon to come up here. So don't copy the one that we have for project, okay? Copy it from index. Okay, copy this from index. Because the one we have for project, we added another class, right? And we don't need that in here. So you copy this. Come to where your nav div ends here. Don't mess it up, okay? So that's gonna show the window, our JavaScript, don't forget. Hopefully I have time to teach you guys JavaScript. If not, you can use Google to learn it. Okay. So see that's showing. Yeah, this is kind of big. Let me see if I can try to reduce it. So what's the at the let me see. So the image logo. So what's this image logo? Let's see, what do we put there? Add in, right. Okay, so let's just call this one padding. Let's give it 20 pixel. Okay, for the image logo. Then come here. this one, let's change it to something else. This 100 pixel, let's change it to 100. View it. I'm able to call this number for you because I've tested it. You know, I've done the hard work of trying to see how it's gonna look, but this is what looks best for me. So let's see if it's gonna look good in here. 100. So view width is the width of the view. 100 view width. Okay, so let's see. That's not bad. That's good. All right, cool. So that means we have our home. It looks good. We lost this, which is fine. We have about me. Looks good. My project looks good. Don't know why this loads. Well, yeah, anyways, okay. Video games. And when we click on our video game, we can still open the new, right? It's still working. Contact me is the last one. All right. We're almost there. Again, copy this from index. Let's go to contact me. Paste this one here. Then same thing from here. Copy it. Then know where this ends. Okay, this is your nav div. Where it ends. Then what else? Can someone guess? JavaScript. Don't know why it puts so much space down here. It's kind of weird. Then let's see the nav div for this one. So it's nav game. And I think nav game is here already. Enough game is here already. So let's see how this looks now. I will just make those changes. That's good. So one thing that I saw in here is that when I click on this, it kind of overlap and it's not looking good, but I didn't fix it, so I'm kind of tired. So but yeah, if you want to fix this so that this will go down and this is going to shrink, you can do that, but it's really not necessary. You know, it'll probably take you a long time to fix it, to make it. But anyways, so now everything should look good on your mobile phone, right? So the next thing that we want to do, since we already deployed our website, right, this what we just did, it's not gonna show in here, you know, if you have deployed your website before, right? So all you have to do is go to your GitHub account, okay? No matter the view that you are, you have to go to your repository. This is your repository, right? So the first thing that we want to change is our CSS, right? So click on this. This is my CSS. My style of CSS, then you edit it because we want to all these changes that is in here, we want to bring it in here. So you click on this edit. So it's gonna be difficult to kind of trace line by line what we change. So I just Control A, copy everything and just replace it. So Control A, Control V. Boom. Okay. Right. So then you don't forget to commit your changes. Commit your changes. So you say, you can say update, like this is optional. You can write anything. Updated CSS to make website mobile responsive. Oh, okay, commit changes, saving. So based on my experience, when you commit and you save, right, then come back here, then see, it's you have to wait a minute for your changes that you just did to build. Like if you don't do that, if you do another change, there's gonna be error, right? So you have to wait for this to turn to green. But first, to see, you see in here, it's still trying to build. So I would advise you that you should wait for it to turn to green. Let me see, it's loading. So just wait for it, okay? If you don't wait for it, yeah, I ran into issues that something broke. So just wait for it, and maybe you can refresh or something. Yeah, might take like 3 minutes or so. You can fast forward the video, you know, but yeah, I'm gonna wait. Still loading. You don't need to do all of this, okay? Just stay here. Okay, we're still waiting for it. Just one more step to go. Okay, so you see the check mark is good. So the next thing that we want to update is about me. So click on about me, the same thing, click on edit. Then go to your code, about me. Please don't make a mistake and copy the wrong thing, okay? Because we are overriding all the files. So Control A, Control C. But before you put everything in here, make sure that it's already working fine on your local environment, okay? Don't forget that. So we Control A, then you Control V. Then commit your changes. We can put description, but I'm okay. Yes, updated for mobile responsiveness. Responsiveness, okay. All right, so let's go back here. So again, you have to do the same thing. You have to do it for all the pages. So probably 2 or 3 minutes, I don't know. almost there. Says some checks. Okay, it's just checking. Okay, that's good. That was faster. So then contact me with a date. Make sure you're copying the right thing, please. Check, double check. Contact me. Control A, Control V. Comment changes. I think, okay, yeah, the commit message should be here. Changes. Or mobile. So you see, it shows there. That's what I'm supposed to have done. Did I commit it? Yeah, I was shocked that it didn't come up. Okay. Oh, three more to go, almost there. Okay. Is it? For this to come to break. 2 or 3 minutes max. So, I mean, I did it, like, just fast forward this part, right? Because I don't think I'll have time to cut this part of the video, okay? So just fast forward it and you'll be good. But again, you have to wait too anyways, so. Everything should work at once, but I don't know why it didn't work for me. Yeah, I made all the changes one after the other very fast and everything failed. So I thought I'll just teach you guys patience. Okay, that's good. So the next one is index. So again, you click on edit, go to your index page. Ctrl A, Ctrl C, Ctrl A, Ctrl V, blah blah blah. Changes for mobile response. Yes. Boom. We have two more, maybe. All right. Next one is my game slide display. So the next in the next class, okay, but don't let me see. But yeah, in the next class, I'm gonna teach you guys how to build webs development website with template. Right, template is website that someone has done that you can just use to design your own website. Okay. It's what most people do, right? So, but I'll teach you guys how to do that, how to make your development fast, development process fast, and where to get free template, okay? So, but okay, good, be good. My games. See, oops. What happened? What did I do? See, can't see. Let me check if this is my game survey. Almost there. That's why it's my project. Was done. Good, that's done. The last one. Last one. So why the last one is building? Just, I mean, just wait for it to build, right? But yeah, this is my. So then you should see all the changes. Yeah. So when I go to my move, so like this is my live website, okay? This is the local one. This is the live one. So when I go to inspect, see, that's gone. This is gone. Then I can. Go to about me, this looks good, everything looks good. my project. Very slow, but it's working. Video games is good. Let me see, contact me. Okay, everything is good. Then contact me. So my project page is showing good right now, but it's still building. That is why, because I've already done this before, right? If it's still building and you check it, it won't show good well. Okay, so yeah, so that's that, guys. That's how to make your website mobile responsive. It's good to look at on mobile phone, and it responds, you know, to the different kind of screen sizes that you have. Okay, so like I said, let's see if this is done. Oh, this is done. Okay, so the next thing that I'm going to teach you guys is how to build a website with web template. You know, you see nice and cool website out there, people actually use template. Like, template is some people have done the code. All you have to do is just download that website, right? Make some changes and then make it your own, right? Change the pictures and letters and everything, you know, and make it your own. So hopefully you guys learned something today. That's the end of today's lessons. All right, so please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with your friends. If you are learning something and you want others to learn, please let them know. Okay, so I'll see you guys in the next class. Bye for now.